Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I am your host, Damon Pettit, and I'm looking forward to this review. I'm reviewing a cigar that I've never had, or a brand that I've never had, a brand that's been around since 2012, so it's fairly young, but what I hear, fairly freaking good. We'll see. We will see. This is the Nomad. And the Nomad cigar, this is the S307. It should be pretty nice, beautiful box pressed. It is got the Ecuadorian Sumatra wrapper, Nicaraguan filler, Ecuadorian Ecuadorian Habano binder. Hello there. And should we just do the strobe effect today? It is a Toro size. You'd usually be paying about $7.95 for it, depending, I guess, on where you are. Again, like I usually say, if you're in New York, you'll probably be spending about, I don't know, $300. Here in Arizona, probably about $7.95. Now, trying a brand new cigar. I wanted a brand new place, so I'm here here at a little airport, right? It's a small airport, little airplanes, and I can't get past this point, so here I am. I wanted something that you could kind of at least see me, so here we are. That's the reason why I brought my little flashlight, so you could see the cigar itself. Let's at least give it a cut. Nice box press, I like. Always like that feel. Let's take a look at. Oh wait, no, don't want that. There we go. This is usually what I use. It's my little bike light. Now, hopefully, I'm not in a bad area anywhere because I don't have my driver's license with me. I kind of forgot that. And it goes a helicopter. Kind of loud. here we go. Looks very nice. Looking very nice. I like the look of the band. I really like the name, considering that is my name spelled backwards. So there's like 100 things already going good for that. Let's throw out a quick hello to everybody real quick. First of all, let's light this bitch, huh? Ooh. I forgot I just filled my lighter up. Wow. Really? Sorry. Very nice. Very nice. Buttery wood taste. Like if you threw some butter on some wood, smoked it. At first, that is just that first bit. Pretty nice. I like that. Let's take a look real quick here. Let's throw out a quick hello to everybody. If you're on Twitter, feel free to find me on Twitter. For a minute, I didn't think it was going to go. Oh, wow. Can't even see that. Okay. Let's do it this way. Very nice. Lots of different, just a little flavor there. The one thing I love, just making sure I'm not causing any problems. I'm going to kind of pair it with a little bit of coffee. It's got a little bit of, it's got some cream, a little bit of sugar, not much sugar, but I'm cutting down on the evil sugar. Well, I tell you what, this cigar keeps going the way it has started, and it's just now started, so let's not get ahead of ourselves. But it's going to be nice. What was I going to say? The name of this cigar, the S307, pretty cool. I like when they actually think of things, and then that's, you know, how they decide to name a cigar. It's nothing new or whatever, but I like that part about the cigar industry. And the S stands for the Sumatra, and 307 stands for the approximate mileage of the Esteli area. So I think that's pretty cool. Nomad Cigar, like I said, has been around since 2012. They have already pretty decently highly thought of. I've been keeping my eyes on it and stuff. Haven't actually lately in the last few months have been pretty busy, so I haven't, you know, gone out and bought a lot of cigars that much. But which brings me to this cigar and how I got it. I want to be fair, so that everybody knows, I did not pay for this cigar. It was sent to me, and really, it's, you know, very thankful that, I'm always stunned when I get a cigar from anybody. So it was very cool. I got this one and a few others that I'll do some reviews on as well. And from Emilio Cigars. I don't know, it's just pretty damn cool. I want to, I don't know. Just want to thank Gary Griffith, and thank you very much. So, beautiful day. It's about, I don't know what it is, in the high 70s right now. Got up to 80 something today. Supposed to get close to 90. So sorry about that. I wanted to send a hello, and I just deleted it. So show us real quick. You have some time, right? A little bit of time. So you don't mind if I do a quick little tweet? All right. Okay. Smoke your cigar. I'm sure if you got one ahead of you, take yourself a little sip of whatever you're drinking. Some water, tea, coffee, whiskey, wine, beer, urine. Hopefully that's not what you got, but, you know, we all have our thing. Let me see here. Mm-hmm. will say, I almost hit a raccoon on the way here. And this is kind of out in the middle. Out in the middle of nowhere. It's only literally about 10 minutes away from where I live. But there are a lot of coyotes out here and stuff like that. And that one raccoon. So I'm hoping it's not pissed off. If it is pissed off and it comes after me, it won't be here for about another 40 minutes because it was pretty fat and it'll take a while for it to get to me. There goes another airplane. See, it's just taking off. Yeah, a little entertainment. There we go. Almost done. Oh, really? I have to redo this, I guess. Sorry, guys. You have to, The tweet part of my thing is going to be done now. There we go. Let's hope it actually sent. So, now I hope everybody's doing well. It's February, which this time, it's usually a little chillier than this here, even in Arizona, in February. But that's not the way it is today, and I'm very happy about that. That's definitely a reason why I live out here, though, is I enjoy blue skies, the sun, and stuff like that. The really cloudy weather really kind of gets me down. I don't think I would do well in a place like, is it like Washington or whatever? Oregon? But this is like perfect right now because this time of year, there's not going to be a ton of bugs, and it's just going to be pretty nice. So that I can handle. A little bit more about this cigar, I guess. It comes in a box of 21, which is a pretty good number. I like that. And I'm going to actually be checking these out. My next stop in at my tobacconist, be at the end of this, less than a week. It's going very nicely with cigar, my cigar is going great with the cigar, with the coffee. That's very nice. As usual, that's usually a very, very good pairing, coffee and a cigar, scotch and a cigar. All that port. But I definitely am a huge, huge fan of coffee. This is the third cigar blend from Nomad Cigar. So this is the third one. I gotta try the other two. And I don't remember the name, damn it. So might want to do yourself a little flavor, Flav. Go on to the intranet, the internet there, and you can take a look at the, just go on YouTube and look at Nomad Cigars, and look up Fred Rewey, which is R-E-W-E-Y, I believe, and there's a few things there. They got their YouTube channel, but one thing I do like is that they are definitely thinking, and they have, he's got his, I don't know if we'll be able to even see it on here, but, okay, well, he's got the S-307, you can barely see it right there, and on this side, he has his Twitter handle on there. You can't fucking see it with my with my flashlight, so sorry. Not very high tech, I know. But that's what makes this fun. But the Twitter handle, it's at G-O-D. Oh my God. It's at Godfodder, like at G-O-D, let's see if I, blah, blah. Let's take a look. I'm going to get it. It doesn't help, oh, there we go, yeah, that's what I thought, G-O-D-F-A-D-R, so at G-O-D-F-A-D-R, and that's Fred Rewey, Nomad Cigar. Get on Twitter, follow him, see what's up. I like all the different cigars. I like all different blends. I love all the different cigar makers. I love all the different cigar places, aging processes, all that. And it's another new one. I like the energy and the attitude and stuff that he brings to the cigar table. So far this cigar is nice. As you can see, it's got a great draw. You can usually see when somebody's smoking a cigar and it's got a really tight draw, and it's like their whole face turns inside out, and then this little tiny puff of smoke comes out. It's like, yeah, that's not really doing it. But this baby, great draw, smoking very nicely. Kind of already see it, but I can see that. Very nice look. There is no wind out here, so, which if there was, I probably wouldn't be out in the middle of nowhere anyway. But the, even so, it looks like it would be holding up pretty decently in some wind. The size of the cigar is the Toro, I believe I already said that, but it's very good size. Was it 6x50, I believe. And, really wanted to, be out near the runway, you know, the plane's kind of going over my head. First of all, it wouldn't be that exciting because it's a small airport, so there's just these little tiny airplanes. And, but it's like really dark. So I guess that's why it's nighttime. But anyway. Oh, yeah. Very. Let's get into some flavor, huh? It's got medium rich flavor for me. It's like medium. It's got a nice medium. Not a punch in the face. It's not spiced up or anything. It's very... it's a deep, deep flavor right now. Let's see what else we got here. paranoid. I keep looking, because I keep hearing something every now and then. I'm just making sure I'm not going to get a raccoon up my ass. I think I'll be okay. Raccoons are actually pretty nice. I've run into a few of them. Not with the car, but just in the wild before, and I've never had a problem with them. Of course, I'm an animal lover, so I think maybe they sense that I'm not going to try to eat them or just fuck with them in any way. So, I'm trying to see if there's any, like, notes that I could say, this reminds me. But I will say this, everybody's got different flavors and different, palates. And so a lot of you will taste like a liver, a liver with some mashed potatoes to the side and a cup of coffee with it. Some of you will taste a filet mignon with a little bit of asparagus and some roasted mushrooms and a Coke. So, when I tell you a flavor that I taste, it's usually going to be something that comes from all the food that I eat, the different palate that I have, and mainly consists of a lot of coffee. And, what else? Sorry. My favorite thing that I taste, that not favorite, but the thing that I taste a lot is a roasted, like a roasted vegetable. Usually some sort of, like I was saying, asparagus or something like that, kind of in there. More than likely, nobody I know will ever say, it tastes like that. But we all have our different things, so. Smoking very nice, drawing very beautifully. Like I said in my other review, that if you go to CigarReviewTV.com, that is where I'm going to, at some point here, have every one of my freaking reviews. Now, there will be a few that are not in there, like 2-3 maybe, of all of them, because they got damaged or whatever, and YouTube completely muted a couple of them, and I didn't somehow lost my copy that I had on my computer, so there's going to be a few that aren't there. But I'm working on that, and working on trying not to have everything housed by YouTube, because you can't really even communicate there anymore, which is sad, because a lot of times somebody will comment on one of my videos, and I can't respond to them. I don't know how the hell they, it, I'm guessing it's either through Google Plus or something like that, but it doesn't allow me to reply in the comment section, even though there's a comment there. Very irritating. So, right now I do have a little comment box on CigarReviewTV.com, but I don't know, like I don't believe you can get notified or whatever, so I'm going to look to get a better comment section going there. I'm going to look to expand that a little bit, make it a little bit better, a little bit nicer. Right now it's real nice and simple, and I'm not looking to complicate it or anything. I would like, when I go to, and this is just my taste, but when I go to a website, I like to be able to navigate it without having to have some sort of engineering degree, and be able to just, if I want to want to learn about Nomad Cigars, so I go there. And by the way, their website is nice. It is easy to navigate, and they have the information about their cigar on there, which I like that. If you're going to have a website, if you're going to have a cigar website, and if you, to me, you got to have your information on there. That's why not? So, black olive, maybe. I don't know. Very nice, though. Very nice tobacco taste. My palate is not refined enough to tell you if this came from the east side or the north side of the, Nicaraguan area. I don't know. But very nice tobacco flavor. My two favorite little extra things that I have in my life, cigars, coffee. I love it. Very, very thankful to be able to ever smoke a cigar, have a cup of coffee, because I know there are people that can't, or at least don't right now, have food. So that always bothers me. Don't like to see that. Just nudge the ash off of there. It's very nice. Smoking very nice. No tunneling or anything like that going on. Very, very, very nice. Now, cigar maker people. I've said this before. What would be very cool, and I don't know if this would be even possible. I don't even know if it'd be a good idea. But what would be kind of cool is if your little, if you're very greatly skilled cigar rollers, cigar makers, had their own little account, Twitter account, or some sort of little number. It could be on the cigar band. And so let's say Jesse rolled these cigars. And I just picked Jesse out of my ass, really. So I'm sure, I don't know if there is a Jesse that rolls cigars. If so, I don't know him. And it could be a girl, because I don't know. I think there are probably girls named Jesse. But anyway, let's just say that they have themselves a little Twitter account or a little special number, 825-8955, whatever. Or just Jesse. Jesse 2, Jesse 859. You can have it right there in the cigar, and you can say, guys, just greatly rolled cigars, fantastic. So you tweet to Nomad Cigars there and say, hey, Jesse did a damn good job, thank you. Pretty cool. I'm just saying, I think it would be fun. But there's the backlash to that part too, where you're going to get some asshole who drank a whole bottle of scotch and accidentally sat on his cigar and then smoked it, and it did not smoke well, and so he blames Jesse for all of his troubles. And so that's where maybe my idea is not so good. But if any of you happen to go ahead and do that, let me know, because I think that'd be cool. But always like that, like I said, I like to feel that box press. It's fun, it's nice, it's aerodynamic. Not really, but I remember when the first box press. Hello everybody, as you can see, it's not nighttime anymore. I'm not at the airport, and I'm not smoking. I will say that my review, somehow the camera must have cut off right in the middle of it and didn't notice. So I did want to make sure that everybody knew that cigar was excellent. Smoked it down to about this much, and didn't even want to put that down, but I had to get going. And it was definitely worth the actual retail cost or whatever. More than worth it. It's priced perfectly, and excellent cigar. You need to go ahead, if you see it in your cigar store, give it a try. If you see it online or however you buy your cigars, give them a try. Definitely worth it. And let's see if maybe next time I do a review, I don't have to do this kind of thing. Unbelievable. Anyway, take care. Thank you very much for watching. It's always fun to do the reviews, and I know they're not short. So take care, and I'll be smoking with you soon.